Dr. Bunim Weinbaum lives in London, England.
The story goes back to when I was a dental student many, many years ago now. And I was teaching on a Sunday morning a Hebrew classes to earn a little extra living while I was studying. And in the Hebrew classes, the problem was the children only used to turn up on Sunday mornings, and they went there from the age of 5 to 13, and many of them went through the system and never really learnt to read. So the headmaster asked if we could get together a system where we can teach the children, to, at least they should be able to graduate by being able to read Hebrew. And we had to first of all decide what levels the children were at. So we made a diagnostic to test the children, a reading diagnostic. It really looked like an eye chart because at the top of the chart was single letters, large single letters, and as it went down, the letters got smaller and the words got bigger. And this is the way we tested the children. And it was at that time my future father-in-law, Mr. Ben Sion Rader, was going to the Rebbe for Yechidus, for an audience with the Rebbe, and he said, I like him to take this reading diagnostic to show the Rebbe. I said, with pleasure. And the Rebbe saw the diagnostic and made a comment on one of the words that had a bad connotation and to change it to something positive. He brought back the diagnostic to England and we used it in the classes and tested the children and graded them and made reading groups for them. The actual system didn't work too well after a while because a lot of the teachers weren't there every week and basically the thing folded. And several months later, I got married and my opportunity to go and see the Rebbe with my wife for the very first time. This was now 1971, Tovshin Lamed Bais, and we went to the Yechidus and we had a long list of different things, projects that we were aiming to do as newly married couple, and we went to see the Rebbe for Yechidus, and the Rebbe read our letter and put the letter down and then started to speak to us about this reading diagnostic, which I'd almost forgotten about by then. And the Rebbe said how important it is to teach Hebrew reading according to the way it was done, you know, originally, which was saying the names of the letters, the names of the vowels, and to say comments Aleph or that method. And he said it affects a child's emunah, their faith, if they learn it that way. The Rebbe continued to say that words that they learn, like from Chumash or from the Siddur, from the prayer book, from the Torah, they become familiar with those words. And we should also, if it happened, that we should make a book, which we at that time we had no idea of making such a thing. We should make sure there aren't trefa, non-kosher animals in the book, pictures of them, or that the pictures of the boys and girls shouldn't be on the same pages. And he finished off this part of the Yechidus by saying we should blaze the trails of Yiddishkeit with Aleph Bais. We now go forward 10 years to 1982, Tovshin Mem Bais, and there was an article in one of the Jewish newspapers in London from the head of the London Board of Jewish Education saying that they have a problem with Hebrew reading. Now this sort of rebounded back to when I was used to teach, and he said if anybody in the community has any ideas, it should come forward. So I approached this Mr. Michael Cohen. I approached him and said that I've been teaching Hebrew reading for many years, mainly to adults. I use a book called Movel HaKriya, and it works very well. And within usually six lessons, I'm able to get them reading. So he invited me round for a meeting and said that if we could get together a few people who would be interested in a project, we could look at this and see how far we can push this forward. So I gathered together a few Chabad people who I knew were interested in chinuch and education. He got a few colleagues together, and we arranged a meeting actually in this very room that I'm sitting in. And the meeting, we had various now ideas of what the Rebbe wanted, but it wasn't necessarily the idea that the head of the London Board of Education wanted. And one of the hardest things was to suggest that we should do a book which was Komets Alephor, naming all the letters, naming all the vowels. And in the end, it was decided we should have a vote which way the book should be done. And one of the people sitting around the room was almost being sarcastic and said, "Why don't you ask the Rebbe?" Pointing to the picture of the Rebbe on the wall there. And his hand was counted as one of the votes to do it. And this is what passed the idea of doing it Komets Alephor. The board member's hands was the one who helped to pass it. So we then had to look at all the various books that were around, and none of them were considered ideal. So it was suggested that we should start from scratch and make this new book. The text we had was the text of Mavla Kriya, but it needed bringing it into the modern era. So having coloured pictures was the ideal. So we made the book, and we followed all the guidelines that the Rebbe had laid down to us 10 years earlier. And the book came out. It's called Mavla Kriya. The text was from Mavla Kriya, and it's called Lamdeini. This book, which sent actually to the Rebbe to show him the book before it was came to print, and the Rebbe's comments was Ma'are Naim, enlightens the eyes. And the book has been out in print now for over 25 years now, and it's being used in all the classrooms, and it's been distributed in England, America, Australia. And I know thousands of people have learnt to read Hebrew as a result of the way the Rebbe gave this horror to us, you know, over 30 years ago.